Hello students, in last lecture we also started this sporulation topic and we have seen about the structure of endospore. Now in today's lecture we will see about the sporulation process that involves stages of sporulation and then we will see about the germination of endospore. So all of you know that sporulation it is a conversion of vegetative cells into spores when that conditions are unfavorable. So this process of converting vegetative cell into spore, it is called as sporulation process. And we have seen in last lecture when there is a deficiency of nutrients, for example nitrogen source here, or if the conditions are unfavorable, that may be temperature, pH or other environmental conditions. So that unfavorable conditions is responsible for the conversion of this vegetative cell into endospore. And this process of conversion of vegetative cell in endospore under unfavorable condition, that is called as sporulation. And this sporulation process, it is divided into many stages. That stages includes that is 0 to that is stage 8 or stage 7. Actually stage 8 is here, that is the release of endospore. So this in Bacillus subtilis, this whole process of sporulation, it takes about 8 hours to complete from stage 0 to stage 7. So here this is the complete stages of sporulation which finally releases the endospore from the bacterial cell. Or here we are going to study about this sporulation process in Bacillus subtilis and which takes about 8 hours to complete these all stages of sporulation. So that we will see here. See, this is the diagram of stages of sporulation which involves many stages. So that we are going to see here. Actually I will explain this diagram here, that is of the stages of sporulation. Now see, this is the bacterial cell, and when there is a vegetative growth of this bacterial cell takes place, so that bacterial get grow in this way here. Means when the conditions are favorable, all nutrients are available to that bacteria, temperature is optimum, pH is optimum and everything is okay, then this bacterial cell, it undergoes the vegetative growth and there is a multiplication of these bacterial cells takes place here. But when conditions are unfavorable, means there is an unavailability of nutrients, temperature is not optimum, pH is not optimum and all the environmental conditions which are required for the growth of bacteria, these are not available, then this bacterial cell, it undergoes the sporulation process. So here, so this is the first stage here, we can say that is the stage 0 actually, and stage 0 means here, that is nothing but the normal conditions of a vegetative cell. Okay, so this is the normal condition of the bacterial cell and that is we called it as a stage 0, this one. Okay, so here now that bacterial cell undergoes the sporulation, and that first stage of sporulation, it is called as axial filament formation stage. So this is the stage 1, which is called as axial filament formation stage, and in this stage that DNA replicates and extends into an axial filament. See, this is the vegetative cell here, or zero stage cell. That cell, it is in normal condition or normal form, so that there is a coiling of this DNA molecule here, or chromosome we can say. And in stage 1, which is called as axial filament formation stage, so in this axial filament formation, that DNA replicates and at the same time it can extend into a long thread like structure which is called as axial filament. So this is the axial filament formation stage, and this axial filament formation stage, that bacterial chromosome become thread like, that is called as the axial filament. And these axial filaments, they get attached to the cytoplasmic membrane or plasma membrane by a structure called as mesosome, and here the elongation of cells also takes place. So this in stage 1, that is in axial filament formation stage, that elongation of bacterial cell takes place, and here this polyhydroxybutyric acid, it is the reserve food material in Bacillus species, and it is utilized in this sporulation process, because sporulation starts when there is a deficiency of nutrients. But to form the endospore, that cells also require some source of food material, and in case of this Bacillus subtilis, this PHBA or polyhydroxybutyric acid, it act as the reserve food material to which is to be utilized during this sporulation process and in axial filament formation stage. So this is the first stage of sporulation, that is called as axial filament formation stage. Now the second stage is it is called as four spore formation. Second stage of sporulation, it is four spore formation. See here, this is the axial filament here, which is formed in the stage 1 in axial filament formation. Second stage is four spore formation, in which that septum forms near one pole of a bacterial cell. See, this is the formation of septum here, and it is forming at the one pole of the bacterial cell. So this formation of septum, it divides that cells into two parts. One is the mother cell and another one is the four spore. So this is the septum formation here, and which divides that cell into two parts. One is the larger portion here, which is called as mother cell, and another one is the smaller portion, which is called as four spore. So that each gets a chromosome, and both of this part, that is mother cell as well as four spore, now they have their own chromosome or their own DNA molecule. So this septum, which is called as the four spore formation second stage, and it forms near one pole, and it separates that four spore from the mother cell. So these two parts, they get separated from each other, and that is by the septum. So this second stage, it is nothing but the formation of septum, and it divides that cell into two parts, that is called as mother cell, which is a larger part, and second one is the four spore, which is a smaller part. Okay, so this is called as the four spore formation. Now the third stage is here, it is called as engulfment of four spore. See, these are the four spore here, asymmetric cell division occurs, which divides that cell into two portion. One is the mother cell, which is a larger portion, and second one is the four spore, which is a smaller portion. That cell membrane forms septum near one end, which encloses a small portion of DNA forming four spore. Now the third stage of sporulation is, it is called as engulfment of four spore. Now see again the diagram. So this is the four spore here, and in stage 3, that is called as engulfment of four spore. See here, the mother cell engulfs the four spore. This is the four spore here, which is a smaller portion, and this is the larger portion, which is called as, that is known as mother cell. So this mother cell, it engulfs this four spore, surrounding it with a second membrane. So there is a formation of second membrane is taking place here, and this process, it is called, it is a third stage of sporulation, which is called as engulfment of four spore. So this engulfment of four spore, it is a third stage of sporulation process, and in that mother cell membrane grows around the four spore and engulfs that four spore. And for spore, now it has two membrane layers. Now the stage 4 is called as synthesis of exosporium. Stage 4, it is called as synthesis of exosporium. So that exosporium, as we have seen in previous lecture, that is the part of structure of endospore. So that is exosporium. See, this is the exosporium, which is the outermost layer, and it is made up of protein that encloses the spore coat. And in some bacterial spore, that exosporium, it is made up of polysaccharide and lipid. See, this is the diagram here, and we have seen that exosporium here, which is made up of proteins. See, this is the exosporium outer membrane here. So next step of sporulation is here, that is formation of exosporium. So this formation of exosporium or synthesis of exosporium, in which that chromosomes of mother cell, it get disintegrated, and there is a exosporium synthesis takes place, and that four spore, it starts forming the primordial cortex between that two membranes. And in this synthesis of exosporium stage, there is a dehydration of cell takes place. So let's have a look at this diagram here, that is formation of exosporium. See, there is a disintegration of that chromosome takes place here. So that chromosomes of mother cell, it get disintegrated. And this is the formation of this exosporium surrounding to that four spore. Okay. So this is about the stage, that is a stage, next one is here, that is the chromosomes of mother cell disintegration. Now the next one, next stage so of, now see, there is the complete formation of the exosporium here. See here, this is the formation or synthesis of the exosporium. Now the next stage is, that is stage 5. So the next stage after exosporium formation, that is called as synthesis of dipicolinic acid. So this calcium dipicolinate, it is actually responsible for the resistance of endospore. So whatever that resistance is there in endospore, they are resistant to sterilizing agent, they are resistant to boiling, they are resistant to ultraviolet radiations. So what, they are resistant to all these things. So this resistance of these endospore, it is due to the presence of this dipicolinic acid, that is dipicolinic acid or the calcium dipicolinate. Okay. So the next stage includes the synthesis of dipicolinic acid, and this production of SASPs and this dipicolinic acid takes place in this stage 5, and there is a incorporation of this calcium ions with dipicolinic acid, which results into the formation of calcium dipicolinate. And there is a further dehydration of the cytoplasm takes place, and here there is a formation of coat layer occurs. So again, see this diagram here, in which there is a, that four spores develops a cortex layer of peptidoglycan between original four spore membrane and the membrane from the mother cell. And here later on, that dipicolinic acid is formed, and finally it combines with calcium ions, and it results into the formation of calcium dipicolinate, and which finally made the spore coat of that endospore. So here there is a formation of spore coat. Okay. Now the next stage is here, that is called as maturation stage. So there is a maturation of that endospore takes place, and finally there is a release of endospore takes place, in which there is a lysis or breakdown of that bacterial cells takes place, and that endospore get releases. So in this way, that sporulation process takes place, which involves many stages. So here finally that mother cell releases endospore, and so that is the process then of sporulation. So after the release of endospore, now that endospore is resistant to sterilization, boiling as well as different types of sterilizing agents. So this is about the stages of sporulation process. Now the next point we will see, that is about the germination of endospore. Now that sporulation process takes place, and that endospore is released here. And this process, it is happening when there is a, that conditions are unfavorable. That is deficiency of nitrogen, that is carbon, hydrogen or nitrogen here. And when there is a deficiency of nitrogen is there, then that bacterial cell convert them into endospore. And that process we have called it as a sporulation. And that we have studied that sporulation in Bacillus species here or Bacillus subtilis. Now, when conditions become favorable, at that time, these endospore, they again get converted to a vegetative cell, which is a metabolically active cell. So when conditions become favorable, so these endospore, now again it get converted to vegetative cell, and this process, it is called as germination of endospore. So that we will see, which are the different stages of germination of endospore. So this germination of endospore, or which is simply called as spore germination. So what is this germination or spore germination or endospore germination? So it is the process in which that endospores again get converted to vegetative form when that conditions become favorable. And generally these endospores remains in dormant state for many years. But when conditions become favorable or under favorable conditions, now that each endospore, it get germinated and it gives rise to a vegetative cell again. So that cycle get repeated. When that vegetative cells are formed, again that when conditions become unfavorable, then these vegetative cells convert themselves into endospore. Now when conditions become favorable, now that endospore convert them to vegetative cell. And this conversion of endospore to vegetative cell under favorable conditions, that is called as endospore germination. And this endospore germination, it involves different stages or process here. The first process is activation, second one is germination, and third one is outgrowth. So the first we will see activation of endospore. So this germination of bacterial spores, it do not occur even when the environment is favorable unless it is first activated. So though that conditions are favorable, but it is very essential to activate that endospore for the germination process. And at first, the spore coat must be damaged by heating for several minutes. So when conditions become favorable at that time, there is a first step is here, that is activation, and in that spore coat, it get damaged by the heating for many minutes. And then after damaging of that spore coat, that germination process starts. So the second step is here, germination. So this activated spore, now it initiates germination after binding of effector molecules. And this binding of effector molecules, it activates the autolysis, and that destroys the peptidoglycan layer of the cortex. Cortex, it is the part of endospore which consists of this peptidoglycan. So when there is a germination is start, that is the second step of germination of endospore. So that effector molecules, they activate the autolysis of the endospore or that cortex, and how? By destroying the peptidoglycan layer. So after the destruction of peptidoglycan layer, that water is taken up by the endospore and calcium dipicolinic acid is released. So that calcium in endospore, there is a presence of that calcium dipicolinate, but when there is a taking of water in germination stage of endospore germination, so that water is taken up and that calcium dipicolinic acid, it is released. And in third stage of endospore germination, after uptaking of that water, there is a swelling of spore, endospore takes place. And along with this swelling of endospore, there is a synthesis of DNA, RNA as well as proteins also takes place. And finally, a small germ cell emerges out from the breaking of the spore coat, and it begins to grow into a vegetative cell. And finally, that vegetative cell get formed. So this is about the stages of endospore germination. So in today's lecture, we have seen about the that sporulation and its stages, and then we have seen about the endospore germination and its stages. So here, friends, if you are not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this YouTube channel so that you will get notifications of the upcoming videos. Thank you.